位观众，那接下来为大家带来这场轻重量级的比赛，对阵双方都是谁呢？来，请看短片。
桑隆里奇是一名比赛经验丰富的传奇老将，他也是巴西柔术黑带和跆拳道黑带，是一个实力不容小觑的多面手。绰号加农炮的他已经在搏击擂台征战20余载，涉足 MMA、 拳击、自由搏击、职业摔角等多个领域。他所参加的具有官方记载的职业 MMA 比赛超过140场，效力过的格斗组织包括 Pancras、 Pride、 King of the Cage、 WEC 等等。里奇的格斗风格多数胜利的为 KO 或者降服，很少有打到判定。纵然现在已经年过四旬，仍然活跃在国际格斗擂台之上。刘文博擅长拳击和巴西柔术，他对格斗运动的喜爱在他运动生涯的形成阶段是显而易见的，在孩提时就在许多业余拳击和格斗比赛中获胜。为此他不惜在高中辍学，将其所有注意力投入到搏击这项在他看来神圣的运动上。其擅长变化多端的组合技曾获得亚洲及太平洋地区的冠军金腰带，在上海站和深圳站发布会都受到了桑隆里奇挑衅的刘文博，在这一场注定与桑隆里奇会碰撞出激烈的火花。
好了，各位亲爱的观众朋友，让我们率先有请蓝方选手桑隆里奇。
Please welcome Shannon the Cannon Rich. Sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous. But on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud. He opens his mouth but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now. The clock's run out. Time's up, over, plow. Snap back to reality. Oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes gravity. Choke, he's so mad but he won't give up. That is he know he won't have it. He knows his whole back to these ropes. It don't matter, he's dope. He knows that but he's broke. He's so stagnant he knows when he goes back to this moment.
And his opponent, representing Beijing ETK Club, he is a two-time national boxing champion representing China. Please make some noise for Lu Wenbo.
接下来出场的就是红方选手刘文博。选手身高186公分，体重93公斤，职业 MMA 战绩8胜5负，代表北京 ET 进化拳馆，他就是来自中国的选手刘文博。
Ladies and gentlemen, battle number 8 of the evening, 3x5-minute rounds in the light heavyweight division. When the action begins, our referee in charge is Mr. Isaac Yap of China versus US of A. Introducing first to my right, fighting out of the blue corner, this man is a pit fighter. Standing at 175 centimeters tall and weighing in at a trim, taut, terrific 93 kilograms even. This man holds a professional MMA record of 55 wins against 82 losses with 15 submissions and 40 by way of knockout. Tonight he's wearing the black shorts with a white and red trim. Representing Team Cannon all the way from US of A. Please give a warm Rebel Arena welcome to Shannon the Cannon Rich. And his opponent to my left, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a boxer, standing at 196 centimeters tall and weighing in at 93 kilograms even. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we're in the black shorts with an orange and white trim. Ladies and gentlemen, holding a professional fight record of 8 wins against 5 losses. 4 by way of knockout, 3 by submission, representing the Beijing ET Clay Club. Ladies and gentlemen, this man is a two-time national boxing champion of China. Representing China, please welcome to the Rebel Arena, Lu Weibo.
南方选手三龙李奇，红方选手刘文博，枪向裁判 ，S Y。
Fighters who set a cage, please.
All right, gentlemen.
Shannon, the cannon.
I said, touch glove, back to your corner.
You know, it's one thing when back you see so much hype in this era of Conor McGregor, I sometimes wonder when two fighters hype it up so much, what is the actual fight going to look like? Is it all show? Are we going to see real fireworks this fight?
Well, we're about to find out. This fight, Poetry by Hong Tu.
Ready?
Wimbo looks like he's going to run at him and headbutt him like E. Honda.
It's on!
Oh, he's trying to punch.
Oh, look at this. Wow.
Throwback clinch.
Lu Weibo's got to be careful. He doesn't gas out early. He's got at him really hard early.
Reminiscent of course, the great.
Oh, my
Akiyama Lord. Don Tai from Pride FC. Here we are. These two fighting hard. And now they've broken.
But he might have gassed himself out in the first 20 seconds of the fight.
Oh, this is a ridiculous fight. Let's see what happens next. If I was Wimbo, I'd be one to use my jab to establish the distance. You got to watch out for the karate kicks of Shannon Rich. He's got an excellent bare-knuckle karate background and is a third-degree black belt in Brazilian jiu-jitsu.
Well, the way that that Lu Weibo came out, it's like the mind games of Shannon Rich worked because he couldn't wait to get his hands on him. And we got to test the cardio out now because man, did he come out hard.
Wimbo throwing some hard shots.
Nice jab there. Was that wobbling or just steady?
Check hook lands for Shannon Rich. Both these fighters taking turns.
Nice cover up there by Rich.
Oh, nice four piece. The kick
Rich
misses.
Is saying, let's stand in the middle and let's get it on.
Inside low kick lands for Wimbo. Outside low kick lands for Shannon.
Definitely the height and reach, and definitely the bigger man is Lu Weibo. Light heavyweight contest scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds.
That's the second check hook that's landed for Shannon Rich. That's something I recommend he keeps doing. Big overhand. Shannon shoots, and he gets the takedown on Wimbo. Passes, slices straight through the guard to quarter guard.
Here we go with the elbows.
Oh, yeah, he's taking full advantage of the 12-6 elbow rule, and he's already opened up a cut on Wimbo.
This is just like their press conference. He took him down.
That's right. Wimbo, one thing about him, he's very strong and he's very tough. He will not give up without a fight. That's exactly what he's giving Shannon. He doesn't have the greatest ground technique, but he also is very strong, and he can stand up out from under just about anyone. Shannon's already opened up a huge cut.
Elbow's coming down. This is close.
The question is whether or not that cut is over or below the eye. If it's over the eye, this fight could be almost over.
Wow. Massive cut opened up by Shannon Rich on Lu Weibo. Lu Weibo's in a world of hurt here.
Lu Weibo did a good job getting on his side. He's got the underhook, but he's got to shrimp out a bit more before he can get to his knees and stand. And he does exactly that.
Oh, he's getting back to the feet. The crowd is going crazy here in Shenzhen for Rebel FC. China versus the world as the referee separates them, and he's probably going to get the cut checked out.
Referee
bit of a breather for both fighters, David.
All right, let's see if we can see on the monitor where the cut actually is.
I got to question the strategy of Lu Weibo. I'm amazed the way that he came out for this fight. It's just too hard too early. And if he loses that fight, that's what I think a lot of people are going to focus on, the start of the fight.
Yeah, the very beginning of a fight makes a big difference. It can set the tone for the entire rest of the match. It looks like that cut is right on the inside of the eyebrow, but it doesn't seem to be inhibiting the vision of Weibo. This fight will continue.
Wait, over there.
But expect Shannon to try to open up more cuts just like that if he gets Wenbo down the ground. His superior ground game is what he's going to use to take advantage of that.
Well, I expect Shannon Ritz to try and get it back down again, and Lou Wenbo trying to keep it on the feet. He's going at him after a little bit of a breather thanks to the cut. And, oh, there we go. There's a takedown as expected.
Big overhand down to the judo trip.
I think Shannon Rich is the one who's won the mind games as well as the fight so far.
Wenbo shrimps back to the guard. He's maintaining head control. He's throwing some strikes. He needs to get his back off of the ground if he's going to be able to get out from under here, though.
What do you think of the cut, David, in a bad position?
Well, it depends. I mean, if he stays on his back, the blood, and it continues to bleed, the blood will run into his eye and inhibit his vision. Here he is getting off his back. He's got his back on the cage now, which is better than his back on the wall, on the ground. But Shannon is looking to take the back at this point. Wenbo should keep his back on the cage. He does not. And Shannon's on his back now, looking to maintain. Look for Shannon to look to sink the hooks as long as he... Using that power, very strong man. And he's starting to rain down the counter punishment on Shannon Rich. Shannon's taking some punishment.
Where did this
he's
come
not
from?
Defending. Will
Where
he stand? He's not reacting. Isaac Yap is right
and
there.
And he stopped
the fight.
Incredible. How did this happen? Shannon Rich was totally in control.
What a dramatic end to this dramatic bout. Shannon Rich still recovering. And Wenbo getting the blood cleaned off of him.
Where did that come from?
I'll tell you what it came from. Shannon let his hips get a little bit too high when he was on top in that position. Wenbo XQ was called a Grammy roll. He wrapped his arm over his elbow and rolled through, dragging Shannon over the top with him, ending up in top position.
Let's look at the replay.
There he is grabbing the glove, rolling, not the glove, but the forearm, and rolling with a Grammy right over the top. From there, Shannon was turtled, was not able to get back. Wenbo is a very large man, and all that pressure on top. Shannon's still a little bit shaky as he's standing back up.
And he puts his hands up and thanks the crowd.
Shannon.
He's still a sportsman, and he will be gracious in defeat, but he's definitely an entertainer. That replay brought to you by Hong 2. There we go. Congratulating Lou Wenbo. That was an incredible fight.
Great show.
In total control and wow, turned on that. On a dime.
Yeah, pure action. And Wenbo the brawler gets the victory over the highly, highly experienced Shannon the Cannon Rich from the USA. Great sign of respect showed for the two fighters. These two guys have been at it ever since this fight was signed, and it's got to be a sigh of relief for both of them to know that they put on a good show and to be able to put it behind them and have a drink together later on tonight.
That's right. And again, Shannon Rich knows how to promote a fight, so he did it very well, and I thought he won the mind games, and he was winning the fight. And again, I'm amazed how that fight turned, because the strategy... Lou Wenbo's got to go back and look at his strategy. Here we go, we'll set it up to the cage side.
The replay, we see the fight ending Grammy roll, This is a great reversal. If you get your arm too deep around someone's waist, they can easily grab that arm and drag you to a bottom position. And things can go from really good to really bad really fast. That's exactly what happened in this fight. Always the entertainer, Lou Winbo, working the crowd. And now Shannon the Cannon.
We saw it on Facebook and social media. How much of that was playing up to the cameras and the video, and how much of it was legitimate?
Well, we have a great match, but I want to let you guys know I got hope for the by him, the guy, he looked bigger, stronger. Lou Winbo, I had the opportunity to throw hard. I thought I had him in the first round. It's very humid here. I don't know if you guys know, but it's super slippery. I couldn't hold him, so it is what it is. I got some people back home watching. Street level player, you guys are watching. So Mike, street level, coming back at the 500 level.
Okay, now, what happened, what was the instructions at the end of the first round from your corner leading into the second?
Come out here hitting hard, fast, and continuously. Hitting from the top of my right, you can make it, you can hit it
to the left. Other shots, he's hitting them hard.
He came through, man, keeps going.
That first 30 seconds was like a WWF slobber knocker. Hitting each other, it was like the old pro man. That was absolutely amazing. Was it adrenaline? He just kept going.
I wanted to put on a fight that the fans like, and I know everybody else.
So stop each other. That was the second round.
I watched Don do that in a pride fight, so I said, oh, why not? Let's try it.
Now, would you think the knockdown would stop the fight with the cut? One other question. Would you like a rematch with Lou Winbo?
Hell yes, baby. Let's do it. Let's work on the time. How's your time? How much you got? Thank you, China! Thank you, Shenzhen! Shenzhen!